grey blue Galway sky, to the constant hum and battle drum of foreign men nearby. And hiding still on Aughrim Hill, Ruth ordered his first reply. Under Ginkle's guns, 1691, Ireland's freedom died. In Limerick town, with swords laid down, they left their native land to a distant place, with loss of face, vowing someday to return. And at James he dared to show he cared, well, they would never know, as their blood was spilled and comrades killed, with many miles to go. And for what of Ireland's glory, lads? For what is glory due? Is it worth to die under Connacht skies, or another country's views? Was it worth the pain of any gain to leave her for all time? Was it worth the toil to leave her spoil to the ones you left behind? Fields of France, in West Alsace, there stood 10,000 men, fighting France's foes, another man's woes, beneath St. Patrick's flag. And in land and field, fallen to his knees, Sarsfield gave his final cry. Oh, that this it were for Ireland, and Ireland died. And for what of Ireland's glory, lads? For what is glory due? Is it worth to die under Connacht skies, or another country's views? Was it worth the pain of any gain to leave her for all time? Was it worth the toil to leave her spoil to the ones you left behind? In Aughrim clay, as they bow today, our wicked times reveal of horror days, of soldiers' blades, Irish fathers on their knees. Lest we forget the blood once wet on Galway's hills of green, was our manhood slain for a cause in vain? Was it all a crazy dream? And for what of Ireland's glory, lads? For what is glory due? Is it worth to die under Connacht skies, or another country's views? Was it worth the pain of any gain to leave her for all time? Was it worth the toil to leave her spoil to the ones you left?